Welcome to the Stroma Life About Jeff the Killer. Go to sleep. If you know what we're talking about, you probably already got goosebumps. If not, stick around to find out about Jeff the Killer. In 2011, a newspaper article about a series of mysterious murders started to go around the internet. In this article, a boy told how he survived the attack of this killer. He woke up in the middle of the night because his window was open. Even though he left it closed when he went to sleep, when he went back to bed after closing the window, he could feel someone staring at him from the dark. He turned around to find a pair of white, vicious eyes shining in the dim light of dawn. As soon as he felt the fear building up, a twisted smile spread under those eyes. The eerie silhouette crawled up to him and whispered, "Go to sleep." Thankfully, the neighbors called the police on time and saved the kid from becoming another victim. The police verified the scene and, based on the boy's description, asked the population to be alert in case they saw someone who matched it. The whole internet was on fire with this news, and rumors spread quickly. No one knew whether the article was real or not, but soon, the supposed true story behind this new internet phenomenon appeared. The story was about Jeffrey Woods, a regular 13-year-old boy that had just moved to a new neighborhood with his parents and his brother. They were all very excited, but on the first day of school, Jeff and his brother Liu were attacked by some bullies. When they tried to rob them with knives, Jeff attacked them and left them badly wounded on the floor. Jeff and his brother didn't say anything about what happened. But on the next day, the police showed up at their house accusing Jeff of attacking the boys. Neither the police nor the parents believed the truth, so Liu lied and took the blame for his brother. He was arrested and taken to the juvenile detention center. A few days later, Jeff and his parents went to a neighbor's birthday party. They all thought it would be a good way to forget what had happened, but no one imagined those violent kids would show up again armed and ready to get back at Jeff. After beating him up, they covered him in alcohol and set fire to him. The doctors managed to save him, but his face was completely disfigured, and something dark started to get hold of Jeff. He'd lost his nose, his face was covered in a white membrane, and since he couldn't see the result of the surgery, he ran to the bathroom and burned off his eyelids, so he never stopped seeing his own face. He also cut out his lips and some of his cheeks so his smile would never fade. When his mother heard the noises, she went into the bathroom and was terrified by the scene. She tried to call her husband for help, but it was too late. Jeff had killed him already. And when she realized, he killed her too. Jeff left home and went to the detention center his brother was in. Before he was killed, Liu woke up. He asked his brother what had happened to his face, and while Jeff woke up to him, he just said, "Go to sleep." No one knows whether this story is true or not, but many people claim they've seen a pale man with no lips or eyelids and with bright black eyes that give you goosebumps. Due to its nature, these stories are impossible to verify. But remember, each time you feel someone watching you from the dark in your room, turn on all the lights and check everywhere. The last thing you hear may be, "Go to sleep." Thank you for watching this Draw My Life. Don't forget to hit the like button and leave us in the comment section down below what you would like to see next time. See you soon!